Good morning, everyone. It's your English class, and today we are going to understand our 10th chapter of our grammar book, that is modal auxiliary verbs. So this chapter we are going to study today. So let's start. So for this, you are advised to open the page number 77 of your grammar book. Let's start from starting. Modals. So these are called the modal auxiliary verbs, and sometimes we say it modal helping verbs. Okay. Look at the following sentences. You should regularly visit your dentist. They must attend tomorrow's meeting. May I use your pen, please? You can park the car in front of our house. You may take this book home. Could you open the door, please? In these sentences, the part of verbs printed in bold letters are called modals. Modals help to express the mood or attitude of the speaker. Right? So, dear students, what do we have to understand? That is, like these bold letter words are called modal auxiliary verbs or modal verbs, right? Like should, must, may, can, may, could. So these all the words are called modal helping verbs, modal auxiliary verbs, or modal verbs, right? So dear students, as we use helping verbs in the tense, like do, does, was, were, is, am, are, has, have. So same we use modal auxiliary verbs, but for different purpose, we use the different modal helping verbs, right? So that is called mood and attitude. Sometimes we want to show the permission. That permission sometimes that is formal or informal or polite. Sometimes we want to show the capacity of the speaker. So different moods and attitudes we want to show by the modal helping verbs, right? Next point. A verb used to express the mood or attitude of a speaker is called a modal. So this thing I have told you. The moods and attitudes expressed in sentences given above are, like sometimes we show the advice, we show the necessity, seeking permission, giving permission in friendly, informal manner, giving permission in formal manner, making a polite request. So these are the moods and attitudes of the speaker. And these moods and the attitudes of speaker, we express the with the modal helping verbs, right? So one by one, we will understand all the modal helping verbs and what type of sense we express with these type of modal helping verbs. This thing also we will understand, right? So B point, commonly used modals. The most commonly used modals are can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, must, ought to, need, and dare. So these are the most important modal helping verbs, and commonly these modal helping verbs are used in our written English and in our spoken English, right? Now let's understand. Modals are used to suggest, and these all the things we suggest with the help of modal helping verbs, right? Permission, ability, possibility, suggestion, advice, duty, obligation, promise, intention, request, necessity, and compulsion, prohibition, wish. So these the like suggestions we suggest with the modal helping verbs. Okay, how to suggest and what are the formation? These all the things we are going to understand. Come on the next page. Yes, come on the C point. Modals are always followed by a main verb. They can't stand on their own unless they are used in a question tag. In the above examples we have used. So dear students, one attribute of modal helping verb we have to understand, that is without main verb we can't use the modal helping verb. Yani ki hamesha modal helping verb ke sath main verb pakka aayegi hi aayegi. Yani ki bina main verb ke hum modal helping verbs ko use nahi kar sakte. You may have seen this like should visit, must attend, may use, can park, may take, could pen. So could open. So these are the main verbs. Means convert may, we have to use the main verbs with the modal helping verbs. You can go on the back page and you can see the examples. like visit, that's a main verb. Attend, use, park, take, open. So we have to put the main verb with the modal auxiliary verbs. Otherwise, we can't use the modal auxiliary verbs. Right? It's the first attributes of modal auxiliary verbs. In this, like one exception case is there. Only in question tag, you can see here. Only in question tag, we can use the modal auxiliary verbs without main verb. यानी कि क्वेश्चन टैग की जो फॉर्मेशन होती है उसमें हम मॉडल ऑक्जुलरी वर्ब्स को यूज कर सकते हैं और वहां पे हम बिना मेन वर्ब के भी वहां पे उन्हें यूज कर सकते हैं. अदरवाइज हम इसे कहीं भी बिना वर्ब के मॉडल ऑक्जुलरी वर्ब्स को यूज नहीं कर सकते. राइट. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, हाउएवर इन क्वेश्चन टैग मॉडल्स कैन बी यूज्ड अलोन. सो दिस थिंग आई हैव टोल्ड यू, लाइक यू कैन लिफ्ट दिस बॉक्स. Can't you? So you can see that this part is called question tag. Can't you? This part is called question tag, and you can observe here, like we haven't used main verb, but in this part we have used. So simply we can say that we can't use a modal helping verb without any main verb, but in just question tag is there, that in that formation without verb we can use the modal helping verbs. Right. See the next sentence. The science teacher will not take his class, will he? So in this part is called question tag. So in this we haven't used any main verb, so that's why we can say that in question tag we can use modal helping verbs without using the main verb. Right. Next point, point number 2, modals do not change form with the person and number of subject. Like you must, we can go, he must go, I must go, she can go, they can go. So dear students, you may have seen that this thing in the tenses. Aapne tenses mein you observe kiya hoga, like when we change the person of the subject or number of the subject, so we have to change the verb. Like if I say I am going there, so with I need to use am. But if I change the subject, if I use you are going there, so with the you we have to use are. He has gone there, they have gone there, so with the he we have to use has, and with the they we have to use have. Right. So according to like person and number of subject we have to change the verb in the tenses, but this does not happen with the modal auxiliary verbs. Right. So whatever subject we are using in this, it doesn't matter what is the number of the subject, what is the person of the subject. Same modal auxiliary verbs we have to use with every type of subject. You must go, you can see that with the you we have used must, with he also must, I also must, we have used here can, and with the like she also we have used can, with they also we have used can. So aapko simply samajhna hai ki jis tarah hum tenses mein subject ke person ya number badal jane se verb change kar dete hain. Theek hai, jis mein kehta hu ki he was going there. So he ke sath maine was use kiya hai. Ab next sentence mein ab he ke sthan pe main you kar dun. Like you were going there. Ab wahan pe main were use kar raha hu. To hame wahan pe jo verb hoti hai, helping verb hoti hai, wo subject ke number aur person ke according change karni hoti hai. But jab hum modal auxiliary verbs use karte hain, wahan pe hum subject ke number aur person ke according hame wahan pe modal auxiliary verb nahi change karni hoti. Right. It is a second attribute of modal auxiliary verbs. Third point, the main verb used after the modal must be in the root form. Present participle, past and past participle form of the verb are never used with the modal. So third attribute of the modal auxiliary verbs, we have to understand that with every type of modal auxiliary verbs which we have discussed already, so we have to use root form, base form, first form. यानी कि सभी मॉडल हेल्पिंग वर्ब के साथ हमें रूट फॉर्म यूज करनी होती है, बेस फॉर्म यूज करनी होती है, फर्स्ट फॉर्म यूज करनी होती है. राइट. नॉट लाइक वी यूज इन द टेंसेस. यू मे हैव सीन दैट इन द टेंसेस लाइक वी कैन राइट हियर ही गोज देयर, यू गो देयर, ही वेंट देयर. सो वेंट इज सेकंड फॉर्म, ही हैज गोन देयर, गोन इज थर्ड फॉर्म. Getting my point. So in this we have to use only root form with every type of subject. Right. So root form we have to use, and without main verb we can't use the modal auxiliary verbs. Just In question tag, we can use modal auxiliary verbs without the main verb, right? Normally, modals are followed by a main verb in a question tag. However, they can be used alone. Modals always have the same form. This point already we have discussed. The main verb used after a modal is always in the root form. These three points we have discussed already. Now, one by one, we are going to understand the senses which we have to use with the modal auxiliary verbs. First sense is that permission. First mood and attitude is that permission. So, dear students, when we have to take the permission or we have to give the permission, permission means agya dena, kisi ko koi kaam karne ki anumati dena. So, whenever we want to show this sense, we need to use three modal auxiliary verbs, which are may, can, and could. May, can, and could. Number of times you may have used that, sir, may I come in? Ma'am, may I come in? So, you are taking permission. So, whenever you have to take permission, so three modal auxiliary verbs you should use. First is may, second is can, third is could. Now, we have to understand what is the difference between them. So, firstly, let's understand about may, can, could. May, can, could are used to suggest permission. Can is informal. May is polite. Could is more polite than may. So, dear students, when like you have to show the sense of informal, right? So, like with whom you have like relations are friendly, not formal. There is no need to do any formality, like your friends. So, frankly, you can speak with them. Right. So with whom your relations are frank, your relations are friendly. So if you want to take the permission from them, so you should use can, because can we use for the informal permission. Right. So two friends like talking. You can see that like two friends are there. So if they want to take the permission, they will use can. Shikha, can I use your book? Aslam. Aslam says that yes, you can, but don't spoil it, please. So, are you getting my point? Like, can we can use when we have to take permission, but that permission should be informal. Informal permission is that with whom our relations are friendly. यानी कि ऐसे लोग जिनसे हमारे संबंध friendly होते हैं, दोस्ताना होते हैं, frank होते हैं. उनके साथ बात करते हुए उनसे कोई चीज लेते हुए हमें फॉर्मेलिटी नहीं करनी पड़ती, औपचारिकता नहीं करनी पड़ती. तो जब उनसे कोई चीज लेते हैं तो उनसे इनके साथ हमें कैन यूज करना पड़ता है. तो ऐसे रिलेशन हमारे अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ होते हैं बेसिकली. तो फ्रेंड्स के साथ हमारे रिलेशन फ्रेंडली होते हैं, फ्रेंक होते हैं, औपचारिकता वाले नहीं होते. सो अगर आपने अपने फ्रेंड से कोई कुछ काम करने की, कोई चीज लेने की परमिशन लेनी है, तो आपको वहां पर कैन यूज करना चाहिए. उसी तरह आपने अपने फ्रेंड को परमिशन देनी है तब भी आप कैन यूज करोगे. लाइक यू कैन सी इन दिस टू एग्जांपल्स, राइट? सो कैन वी हैव अंडरस्टूड कैन वी यूज टू टेक परमिशन, बट दैट परमिशन शुड बी इनफॉर्मल. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट मे. मे वी हैव टू यूज फॉर द पोलाइट परमिशन बेसिकली व्हेन आवर रिलेशन आर फॉर्मल, राइट? व्हेन आवर रिलेशन आर फॉर्मल, so in that condition we should use may for the politeness. Like you like keep speaking to your teachers like, sir, may I go there? Sir, may I go for washroom? So you keep saying like keep using the may word, may modal auxiliary verbs, because with your teachers your relation is formal, that is not informal. Secondly, you have to show the politeness, right? So for the polite request you should use may. Third is could. Could we can use for very politeness, when we have to show the very politeness in your permission. So in that condition you can use could, right? You say to your teachers, sir, may I come in? So instead of using may, you can use their could. Could I come in, sir? Right? So by the could, you like it will appear that you want to show the very polite permission. You want to take the very polite permission, right? So then you can use could. So read this point. Since Shikha and Aslam are friends, they don't have to be formal. So they have used can, a student talking to her teacher. So are you getting my point in this? Shikha and Aslam, two friends are there, so they are talking to each other. So they are friends, so that's why their relation is like informal, friendly relation is there. So whenever Shikha will take anything from Aslam, so in that condition, Shikha will use can, and Aslam will also use can for taking permission and for giving permission. Clear? Next point, a student talking to her teacher, Garima, may I go to library, ma'am? Teacher, yes, you may. What books do you want? So now you can like see here, like they have used may. Why? Because their relations are formal. They have to show the formality in this, with the politeness. So Garima is talking with her teacher. So that's why whenever like Garima will take permission from her teacher, so she will use may instead of using can. So that's why she has used here, may I go to the library, ma'am? Ma'am says that, yes, you may. What books do you want? Right? Next, in this case, both the students and teachers are being formal. Garima is respectful and the teacher is also giving a formal permission. A subordinate talking to his officer. Ek person apne officer se baat kar raha hai. Uska colleague hai. Abhinav says to his officer, sir, could you grant me 2 days leave? Officer says that you may take leave if there is nothing urgent in the office. Here the subordinate is being very polite with the officer, is giving permission, formal permission. So dear students, here you can observe that Abhinav, that is using could here. Why? Because he want to take the permission for leave, and secondly, he want to put very politeness in his permission. So that's why he has used here could, but officer is giving formal permission with the normal politeness. That's why he has used may, right? So it depends on your sense, which word you want to use. You can use either could or may. It's totally up to you. But when you use could, it means you want to show the very politeness, strong politeness in your permission. But if you use may, it means you are being formal. Right? So could or may ko dono mein se kuch bhi, koi bhi word use kar sakte ho. Dono hi words theek hote hain. But jahan pe aapko apni permission ke andar ek strong politeness ko lana ho, vinamrata ko lana ho, strong vinamrata ko lana ho, wahan pe aapne could use karna hai. Jab formality karte ho, formal bante ho, tab aapne may use karna hota, right? Next point. So permission, about permission, we have understood that can I use your telephone, that's the informal permission. May I use your telephone, that's a formal permission. Could I use your telephone? That is very polite permission. Yes, you may. Permission granted formally. No, you may not. Permission denied formally. Right? So in this way, dear student, like you need to use these modal auxiliary verbs for the permission. Now, dear students, on the behalf of this understanding, we will do exercise first. Please wait. Please wait. Yes, please. So now you have to raise your hand. If you know the answer, I will ask. Means we will do this exercise. Okay, so can you tell me which modal auxiliary verbs will come in the first fill-up? Raise your hand. Firstly, let me do some setting from my end. Please wait. Please wait. Stay connected. Please wait. Let me extend the size of this. Yes, please. So, first fill-up is that I come to see you tomorrow, sir. Yes, you may come. So for polite means formal. So which word will come here? Can, could, or may? Who will let me know? Raise your hand, please. Raise your hand, who can give the answer? Okay, Ekansh, you please tell me.
Sir, can I come to see you tomorrow?
Can I come to see you tomorrow? Ekansh? May will come because we want to show the polite permission. So polite permission is that shows that you want to take the formal permission. So for the formal permission, you should use may. Right? Next sentence. I leave the school an hour early. So may I leave, can I leave, or could I leave? So which modal will come here? Who will let me know? Manika, you please tell me.
Could I leave?
Yes, could I leave the school an hour early? Very good. So here we want to show the very politeness, strong politeness in our permission. So that's why we need to use here could. So third is that, John, you stay with us as long as you like. So informal. So which modal auxiliary will come? Modal auxiliary verb will come. Who will let me know? Rishabh, you please tell me. Sia and Rishabh, you please tell me.
Sir, can.
Can. Yes, because we want to like use here informal permission. For the informal permission, we should use can. Next, I have an important match. I have your bat, please. So here, that is informal permission. So which modal auxiliary verb will come? Who will let me know? Muskan, you please tell me. Muskan,
sir,
please
can.
Tell me. Can, yes, because that
is formal permission.
Very good, very good. Right answer. Because that's an informal permission. Next, give me a little water to drink, sir. Very polite. Who will let me know? Kesar, you please tell me. Kesar, you please tell me.
Could give me a little water to drink, sir?
Yes, very good. Here, could will come. Could you give me little water to drink, sir? So you also will come here. Very good. Right answer. So, dear students, in this way, we should use these modal auxiliary verbs. Okay. So one more thing I want to ask you, dear students. Suppose you are going in a bus and you want to take the seat, and like someone is sitting there and you want to take the seat, you want for sitting. So what will you use? Will you say that, could I sit here, or may I sit here, or can I sit here? Who will let me know? Again, understand the situation. Suppose करो कि आप एक बस में जा रहे हो, आपको बैठना है अपनी एक सीट पे, और सीट पे कोई बैठा है, फिर भी स्पेस है, आप उसने आप आपने उससे पूछना है कि सर क्या मैं यहाँ बैठ जाऊं? तो अब क्या यूज करो? Can I sit here, or could I sit here, or may I sit here? Who will let me know? With the explanation, you need to like tell me. Ekansh, you please tell me.
Sir, may I sit here?
May I sit here? Why? Why not could or can?
Sir, क्योंकि may I मतलब क्या मैं यहाँ पे बैठ सकता हूँ? Sir, may I मतलब.